What is going on, everyone? It's Kelly here, and I have been running around like a mad woman. Gabe and I have 2 days to get everything ready before we go to Washington. It's going to be freezing there, and I own no cold weather clothes. So, I'm trying to find some pants right now. Just went to Best Buy, spent probably way too much money on like a new GoPro 9, this little light thingy, some cords, some batteries, all that good stuff. But right now, taking a little break, and I'm gonna go ahead back to my mom's house. I'm gonna have my grandma, grandpa, and my brother over, and I'm gonna go ahead and fry up some of this catfish that Blue Gabe and I caught in Venice, Louisiana. So we're gonna have a little catfish fry at my mom's house, and I'll see you guys there. I'll check out our cooler of fish here that Gabe and I brought back from Venice, Louisiana. We got some beautiful redfish, and of course the blue catfish that I wanted to fry up. We're gonna go ahead and shut that. It's pretty hot out here. Sun's going down, and right now is like the hottest time of the day. So, got some blue catfish right here, and I've only filleted catfish one time, and I did like the second half part. One of the guys in Louisiana took the catfish and pegged him on a hook, and then cut him right behind the head, took pliers, and peeled the skin off. It was a really cool, easy, fast way to fillet the fish. However, I don't have a hook or a peg or anything to stick it on, so I'm just going to fillet it like I would a normal fish. Now, these catfish have been sitting on ice for about 24 hours or so. They're still perfectly fine to eat. However, just like any other meat or fish, deer, any type of animal, once it's been just kind of relaxing, the muscles relax because the animal's relaxed. So the meat will get a little bit more on the mushier side. So right here, I'm gonna go ahead and make my cut like I would any other fish. They got extremely hard heads. And then I'm just gonna take my knife and go right down the top, like so. Ooh. Once I pass that rib cage, I'm gonna go ahead and poke my knife all the way through and fillet it, and follow that rib, or follow that backbone all the way down, like so. Okay, so you go ahead and lift up your fillet, and fillet it like a normal fish, right down that backbone. Like I said, these ones are gonna be a little bit trickier because the meat is a lot softer, but that's all right. We're just gonna work our knife around that rib bone, without poking yourself. And there is our catfish fillet right there. Now, just go ahead and skin it like you would any other fish. This is gonna be a little tricky because the fish is a little slimy and the meat is a lot more soft than it normally would be. But just keep your knife flat and just work your way up that skin. Like so. There you go. That is our catfish fillet. I'm gonna go ahead and fillet the rest of these catfish, and then I'll see you guys in the kitchen. All right, we have our catfish. I've been letting it sit in some milk for probably about 5 or 10 minutes here. You can soak your fish in milk to get rid of any type of fishy or dirt or muddy taste. The catfish normally does not have that taste, but I did it just because it's a freshwater fish, and I usually normally salt water, and I just did it because I wanted to. All right, come over here. I got my brother behind the camera right now, Ty Ty Insta on Instagram. So we're gonna go ahead and add a little bit of heavy whipping cream to our egg wash here. That's gonna be the base for when we batter our fish.
Give it a little whip. So this fried catfish is going to be gluten-free. I have some almond flour and some gluten-free seasoned breadcrumbs. I already put the almond flour in our bowl here. Gonna pour some breadcrumbs in there, like so. And a little bit of magic redfish seasoning. Oh yeah. Alright. Give that a little mix up with your hands there. Alright, three-step process. Take your fish. Put it in the wash. I was thinking about using mayonnaise too. I usually use mayonnaise with my chicken. You coat your chicken in mayonnaise before you cook it. Gives you some juice to your chicken. A little cook tip. You're gonna bread all your fish. Boom. I'm so excited for this catfish. Man, I go to Venice, Louisiana, and a lot of people go there for yellowfin tuna. I will go there just to catch these blue catfish because they are so good to eat. Like I say in all my videos, I don't eat fried food, but let me tell you, fried catfish, one of my favorite things. I was on an Oceana Gear fishing trip over in Venice, Louisiana this past summer, and my friend Derek whipped up some fried catfish for everyone, and oh my gosh, it was just so good. So now, every time I go to Venice, I start fishing for them blue cats right off the pier there. Speaking of fishing for the blue cats, let me roll you guys some footage of Blue Gabe and I at the Cypress Marina in Venice, Louisiana, catching these blue catfish. Alright guys, so we're at our super secret blue catfish spot right now. Look, they just cleaned a big old yellowfin tuna. Check it out. Look at that. And that's just a little hint of why these blue catfish are here at the splay table. They love yellowfin tuna carcass.
But they don't know we're here to catch it.
They don't. I'm kind of surprised. This marina right now is pretty dead. But every time I do catch a big blue cat, it is right here. So we're gonna give it a try. So right here we have a bloodline of a yellowfin tuna belly that we got from one of the flay tables. You're gonna stick the hook in, skin first, wiggle it in there, and then out the meat, just like that. Big bait, big fish.
Judging by that bait, you're going after Moby Dick.
You'll be surprised. If we get a big cat, he's gonna be big. Now it's a waiting game.
Did the saltwater catfish not get in here? Look at that huge rat! Oh my god!
Where do you see a rat?
Right there!
Oh my goodness! Oh, he just... There was a rat there. There's some stuff nibbling on it.
Yeah, you can't let all that line up.
I know, there's a lot of rocks here. Oh, here we go. This is your cat.
What is that?
That's a blue cat.
A blue cat. First one on the board.
Good eating size.
Blue cat on the board.
That's a little guy, but he's perfect for eating. Oh, I was gonna move the rod. Oh, look at that big old cobweb.
Can we talk about the rat we just saw?
Yo, there was a rat.
It was as big as Redneck.
That was going after that yellowfin tuna carcass. I might need pliers.
That thing was just right there.
Hey, baby. Can I get the pliers up in here?
You guys, this is what happens when you're with Kelly Young. I just get a brand new boat, and we're fishing off land. Find my pliers. I'm also fully sponsored by Danco and just had to buy some because didn't bring any with me.
It's called being a human being. We are all not perfect. Teamwork. Thanks, boo. Dinner? Dinner.
No. That one?
Yes, sir. The hardest thing about this spot is getting them out of the rocks. When you threw back.
What you got?
I got a baby blue. Species targeted.
What face was that?
It was the I don't want to get poked by a blue cat face. Hold up. One more
ninja
spin.
Hands.
Got it. Can I see them pliers, please? Pliers just work so well. And I still got my bait.
What you fishing for way out there?
Yellowfin tuna.
That's how you get hung up. You gotta throw with the current. Oh, I just got bit hard.
I'm just waiting for a monster to... Oh, that's a good one. That's a little big one. What?
It slipped.
You just like releasing all of your catfish.
It slipped. Hey, you know what they say? If you catch them, you got to clean them. I don't have to clean that one. You got Moby Dick?
He's definitely bigger than the other ones we've been catching. I don't think he's huge.
He's fighting like he's big. He's just giving that old salty a test.
He is. This rod's doing great. Oh, there he is.
Goodness.
Oh, he's a decent size.
Dang sure is. Here, come here. Bring him here.
He's acting like a log.
I'm going to bust my butt.
Yep, I've been there many times. Whoa. Be careful.
Look at this big one. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Yeah.
Now the key word is to not bust my butt.
All right, let me help you out.
Oh, we got dirt on the screen. Or water.
That's all right.
Well...
Thanks, Boo, for risking your life going down there.
Kelly has officially caught a bigger catfish than me.
You did noodle some pretty big ones, though. Ow.
We're going to lay him right there and go get the pliers.
All right.
Here, let me clean the lens. Here, are you planning on eating that big thing?
Yeah. Look at the slime on this line, on this leader here. That's gross.
All right, come on. Let's go. We got fish to catch.
Ew.
I'm okay. Getting out fish really bad.
Yo, but it's okay because you haven't been here before. Oh, no. Where did the hook go?
Yeah, we don't have any more hooks, so.
All right, I got it.
That's a big, respectful catfish.
He is. He's very nice. Whew.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna let this one go. We have some smaller ones. in the cooler that we're gonna cook up, but
maybe you can trade them for some of those big old tuna. Hey, she's got fresh catfish if y'all want to trade.
Alright, let's go ahead and release this one. Let's go.
I'm not getting back into rocks, so you better chunk that thing.
Alright, no, I'm gonna
just chunk it.
I don't wanna chunk him.
Chunk him!
I didn't see a rod. I thought there were two.
Chunk him!
There's rocks!
On three. 1, 2, 3.
I bit my finger on the way out!
Look, just swim away, healthy as can be.
Ow. So I usually go down in the water and I'll release them. However, those rocks are insanely slippery, so I just went ahead and chucked them back. But he did get revenge on me. He grabbed my thumb because I very lightly put my thumb in his mouth and that thing clamped down. Now the reason all these blue catfish are here right now is because when the tuna boats come in, check it out, they clean their tuna right here at the fillet station.
Not really on these fish because they don't live in that cold, cold water.
So these blue catfish get super spoiled and they love that prime yellowfin tuna. So that's why we have yellowfin tuna carcass and bloodline. That's what we're using for bait.
I mean, it's aight.
It's aight.
Bigger than mine.
You want this one?
Yeah, keep going.
All right, I can't turn this one loose, guys. The boss has spoken. Look here. We got redfish. We got sheep's head. And catfish. There's a lot of people around the country that would die to catch that many catfish.
So it's getting dark right now. Gabe and I just doubled up on blue cats. He got one a little bigger, but I got mine right here. I'm gonna go throw them on ice and we're gonna continue to fish until the mosquitoes take over. Wish us luck.
We have some broccoli and carrots over here. Always need to get those veggies in, especially when you're eating fried food. All right, we got our peanut oil. Ooh, it's gonna be hot. All right, let's go ahead and put some of these bad boys in. Ooh, it's gonna cook really fast. Down a little bit.
Fish? What you think?
She's like, excuse me, can I have some fish? Look at Jazzy. Jazzy, come here.
Hello.
Hello. Last batch of catfish nuggets here. They are looking good, looking good. Now I learned this little trick from Blue Gabe actually, is when you fry anything, put it on a grate, and then it kind of air dries. Because if you put them on napkins, they tend to get a little soggy. And I noticed that with the last catfish I cooked in Texas when I also did a cactus pick and cook. So this is my, oh no, we have a fallen soldier. So this is my little grate I just kind of found in my mom's kitchen here, but it's doing good, it's doing good. Oh, this smells so amazing. All right, so we're gonna let that cool for a little bit. Get back up there.
Jazzy, you smelling some catfish?
This is Jazzy, guys. She's been in a few of my first, like, maybe first 5 videos she's in there, but now she's making a reappearance in this one. She's a sweetheart.
Say hi, Jazzy. Say hello. She's like, can I have some fish, please?
All right, guys. We're taking it to the back porch right now. All right. We got my mom here that you guys seen in my recent snook video where she caught the slot snook.
Yep.
We have my grandma over there. Say hi.
Hi.
And we have my grandpa over here. Right now we're about to dig into some Louisiana blue catfish.
Chant, chant, chant.
Oh, you already got spoons for there.
It's a good chant.
I'm gonna give you all just a little taster at first and you guys can get some more. Where are you, Grandma? You ain't getting any of this.
Camera.
Gotta get my brother. He's been behind the camera this whole time, helping me film in the kitchen. All right, give me this camera.
All right,
growing out the stash. All right, hold on. This is gonna get a little messy. Hold up, let me see if I can flip this camera. Sorry, guys, the sun is going down right now. What? All right, Mama Dukes, let's go. Hold up, let me flip this. Taste test number one. Louisiana blue catfish. Alright, Grandpa.
A little crunch to it. I like it.
Good.
It's good? And it's gluten free. Alright, Tyler and Grandma.
I haven't tried it yet. Can you get right?
Yeah. Champ, can you not? Tyler.
That's better than blue gauge.
Nah.
It is good, Jim.
It's good? You like
I'm
it?
I'm surprised.
<It's better. laughs> you're surprised.
I haven't had catfish for years. It's been years since I lived in South Carolina.
Oh my goodness. Jazzy, I see you creeping over there.
Really good, Kelly.
Awesome. All right, guys. Let me go ahead and give it a try.
You need to join us.
Mmm. That's why I go to Louisiana. And it's gluten free. All right, guys, we're gonna go ahead and sit down and eat this meal. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for subscribing, commenting, liking, doing everything you can to support my channel, because without you guys, I can't have a YouTube channel. So I'll see you guys on the next video. See ya.
Mom, I'm gonna tell you the five keys to happiness.
Okay. Right.
One, find a woman who makes you laugh. Two, find a woman that listens. Three, find a woman that makes you smile. Four, find a woman that's good in bed. And the most important part, number five, make sure they don't find out about each other.
Oh my goodness.
Tyler,
this is terrible.
Haven't you been hanging around?
I heard that one on the radio. Here we go.
Someone's to go on.
Joke of the day. Them pecan farmers are a little nutty.
Pecan caramel pumpkin.
So hey, much grandma. For my gluten-free recipe.
Grandma, is it because pecan or pecan?
My mom just made cake. I can't turn down cake, so...
Yeah.